What if I told you there were institutions predicting the future every day across the globe and exploiting people for profit based off what they find? If you were to take a guess, who would you think they are? Government agencies? Corrupt banks? The people that ask for a 25% tip on those little kiosks when you get takeout? If you answered one of those, you're probably right, but today we're talking about casinos. If you've ever been to one, you'd know there's an almost guaranteed chance they'd have these three games: slots, blackjack, and roulette. Now, if you're an irresponsible adult that went to the casino trying to make money, which one of these three games would you pick? Slots can have extremely rare but insanely high payouts. Blackjack gives you a little bit more control over your bets, and roulette falls somewhere in between. The real answer to this question would be to not go to the casino in the first place because of something called the house edge. It's baked into every game, and what it does is it ensures that over time, you're virtually guaranteed to lose money. But how do they do this? The answer is expected values. In most math classes, whenever expected values are introduced, they look something like this. Now, I know this can seem a bit intimidating, especially if it's your first time seeing this formula. But don't worry, because there's a more intuitive way to understand it. Let me illustrate. Let's say I know a game with 5 possible payouts that range from 1 to 5 times the money I put down. In total, there's 6 outcomes. I either lose the game or I win one of the 5 payouts. Assuming each outcome is equally likely and my initial bet is 100, to find the average amount of money I can expect to win, we just take the average of these outcomes by adding up all my potential winnings and dividing by 6. The problem is, outcomes in casinos are never equally likely. They're almost always in favor of you losing money because that's how they profit. This is where something called weighted averages comes in. Weighted averages take the different outcomes of an event and pair it with the probability of that event happening. If this setup looks similar to the regular average we just found, that's because regular averages are just weighted averages where all probabilities are equal and add up to 1. That was a mouthful. So definitely pause if you need to make sure everything is clear. Back to our example though. Let's say the probability of losing the game is 75%, and the remaining 25% is split among the other 5 payouts equally. Now if we want to find an average, it makes sense to give the losing outcome more influence over the final number, because it's going to happen more often. So we do that, and calculate the average with these numbers, and as you can see, it's much smaller than our regular average. In fact, because it's 0, there's actually no benefit to playing this game with these odds. Now, remember this equation? Well, we just found the expected value of our imaginary casino game, which means whenever you see this formula, all you need to think of is taking a weighted average of all the possible outcomes of a given event X. This brings us back to house edge, because the process we just went through is the exact same thing casinos do to make sure every gambler nets them profit if they keep playing. The only difference is casinos want your expected values to be negative. And if you don't believe me, just look at the expected values for some of the bets you can make in roulette. This game is fine-tuned to chip away at your money over time. And that goes for every game in the casino, unless you count cards in blackjack, which is exactly why they kick people out for doing it. And there you have it. The math behind expected values.